everyone, how's it going? My name is Anna and welcome back to my channel, and I bet you already saw the first semi-final, so let's talk about that. First, I want to congratulate all of those 10 finalists, and now let's talk about the surprises from that evening. So everything was very predictable, but Albania and Ireland managed to qualify to the final and Greece did not. I have to be honest and say that I am extremely happy that Albania and Ireland did it. I've always liked them since the beginning and I have already talked to you about this song, so I am very happy. But I know that many people don't feel these songs as much as I do, and I know that people are not very happy with this. Albania for me, which was number 3, it was such a big moment. I can't explain it, because once I heard his voice, I was like, ah! Oh! You know, I had that reaction. His voice is extremely beautiful. The way he sings, he can reach any notes he wants, you know? Yeah, he sings very well with so much intensity. And not only that, but he always did something different with his voice. If you hear the studio version, he doesn't go that high. If you go see his Amsterdam concert, he didn't do all those higher notes. He did some, but not like that. And yesterday, he really surprised me. He just sang it the way he wanted to. You know, he was feeling it. I mean, it's crazy to see how he was able to feel all that big stage with only his voice. So I guess he really touched me. The staging was very nice as well, because it was in Albania's colors. So yeah, it was nice. It was a very nice performance. It was number 3 and it was in the beginning, and still I can't forget it, you know? It's something that I am so extremely excited to see it live on the grand final. So now about Ireland, and what we saw from Ireland was the music video on stage. They had that lamp, so they kind of recreated a bit of the street, and they added the two dancers from the music video, which I thought it was very clever, because you know, it really grows and it really brings some LGBT vibes to the song, because otherwise we wouldn't understand it. And the way they interact with each other, again, as I said this before, is so sweet, because you see it more than just a love in terms of a romantic level. You see it as a true friendship, as two people that care for each other, as two people that share those moments. And what they did at the beginning, which I thought it was very correct, was to show just the singer and the pianist so that you could get to know them and pay attention to them, because once the dancers came in, all you could look at was the dancers. So they did it in a very nice way that you could not only pay attention to the lovers but also to the singer and the back vocals. And that's actually kind of funny, because it seems that in that street where the dancers were walking by, there were some street artists being those street artists, the singer and the pianist. It was a very nice way to tell the story. It was very smooth and very sweet and very romantic. It was one of those heartwarming moments, you know? I like the plans on the cameras and the camera's movements on the Irish song, because they could really manage and create a connection between the singer and the pianist and the dancers. It was an intimate moment with a huge connection with the four of them. Now let's talk about something that kind of made us all very sad, didn't it? Greece didn't qualify. Well, I'm sure everyone was expecting it to qualify and even in the final would take a very high position, but that didn't happen, and I have to say I'm quite sad, because I really like the Greek song. But I have to be honest with you and say that when I saw the live performance, I didn't think of it as something strong as it should be. The thing is that the song itself, if you only hear the song, is something very powerful. The music video as well, it has a lot of intensity. You kind of, you know, you are suffering with them, like what's happening there, and you kind of understand all of the message of the song through the music video. But on the live performance, I don't think that happened. I think that it wasn't as intense as I thought it would be, and it didn't tell the story for those who are not familiar with the lyrics, because, well, she sings in Greek, so not everyone will understand, of course. And if you show this song to someone else that never read the lyrics, never translated them, well, they might not understand what the music is about. And I think that the staging in this song would be a great opportunity to show the despair, to show strength, and to show how a country can raise high even though all the odds are against it. But I didn't feel that while watching the live performance. I just think that for those who didn't know the meaning of the song, they couldn't explain it very well. And actually on that instrumental only moment, I wanted to see her fighting for something, you know, because that's what the song is about. I'm not criticizing the song, I still love the song, come on, I really wanted it to go to the final. But what I think is that the song is so strong that the staging wasn't strong enough to hold it, you know? But hey, we should really respect what Greece did, because the lyrics are amazing, she sings amazingly, and the thing is that it made everyone from Greece very, very proud, and that is probably the most important thing. So this was my reaction and my little comments about the show last night. Tell me, what did you think about the first semi-final? Which country surprised you? And let me know if there was any country that was left behind that you wanted it to qualify. Thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed, and don't forget to subscribe. Bye!